Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous topic we have discussed about the coordination compound, as well as we have also discussed about the coordination bond. And now in this topic, let me talk about the postulates of Werner's theory. So friends, now here we are going to talk about the postulates of the Werner theory for the complexes, or we could also call it as that is coordination compounds. So for that, so now let us understand what are those postulates. So talking about the first one, that is, two types of valencies are shown by the most metallic elements whenever they are exhibiting a complex, that is a coordination compound. The first one is primary valence and the second one is secondary valence. So now let us understand in deep detail, that is, what is primary valence and what is secondary valence. So talking about the next point, that is, the tendency of every metal is to satisfy both the primary and the secondary valencies. And that's the reason, that is, the number of the secondary valencies shown by each metal is fixed. And the secondary valencies is always directed towards the fixed position in space. So therefore, this were all the postulates. And now let me elaborate that what is actually the primary sphere, or what is actually the primary valency and the secondary valency. So according to Werner's, or there are two valencies. For example, suppose if I'm talking about complex like where cobalt is nothing but the central atom, or the central metal atom. So in that case, there will be two spheres. So one of the sphere, it will be called as a primary sphere, and the second will be called as a secondary sphere. The primary sphere is the one which is present at the outermost, and where basically we can find that is those groups or those elements or those atoms which are associated with the central atom, they are out of the sphere, as you can see. And that's the reason that whenever those compounds are dissolved in water, they get ionized easily. And that's the reason this Cl, that is this 3Cl atoms, it will get dissociated, or it will get ionized. So talking about the other groups, so this was the outer shell, and that is known as the primary shell, to which basically the Cl groups are at the outer surface of it. While talking about the secondary one, so the secondary phase is basically known as coordination sphere, and that sphere is within, and actually it is denoted by a dotted line, but I have represented it here with a red ink so that we could understand that is there are two spheres, and to which basically there are the other ligands or other groups which are associated with it with a coordination bond. And that's the reason, suppose if I'm talking about the other molecules, like suppose NH3, here also there is NH3, so therefore there are six NH3 groups, that is I'm talking about as an example. So this six NH3 groups are basically present in the secondary sphere, or they are known as coordination spheres. So those NH3 groups which are present at the secondary sphere, they are very much associated with the metal, and even though if we dissolve those complex in water, they won't get ionized easily. And that's the reason the bond between this cobalt and this NH3 is coordination covalent bond, while the bond between this cobalt and this Cl is basically an ionic bond, and that's the reason it ionizes very easily. So this was the theory of Werner for the coordination compounds, and based on that only he assumed, that is, if those ligands or if those compounds which are having a coordination bond with the central atom, they should be included within this square bracket. And that's the reason that if you see any kind of representation where this square bracket means that is the coordination bond is between the central atom and this ligand, while if those other groups are outside this bracket, then they are representing the primary sphere, or those elements are belonging to the primary sphere where it can ionize very easily. And that's the reason that is whenever this complex it will get ionized, it will form, that is, CONH3 6 having 3+ charge, as well as 3Cl- charge, and in this case this 3Cl- ions are ionizable, while this is not. So this was nothing but a brief explanation about the Werner's theory, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and I hope I'll see you next time. Till then, don't forget to subscribe Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.